Mr. Kelso?
That's what the sign on the door says, miss. There's no need to come into the office, Ms. Lichtman. If you accept the settlement, all you need to do is sign here.
I don't accept the settlement.
What do you mean you don't accept? I think you're pushing your luck, lady. This seems to be a ridiculously generous settlement. A $200 policy with a $20,000 payout? You should...
I don't want the money.
What do you mean you don't want the money?
I want you to investigate this case. I feel my friend may have been the victim of foul play.
Okay. Let me get the case file.
There's got to be more in these files.
And then the louse calls and says he's going to marry an English girl. Do you think this looks just as you like for my complexion? It's quite hard to concentrate when you're standing there staring at me.
something else in that report. I know it.
Sounds like your friend took a hell of a fall. I'm sorry for your loss.
And then the lass calls and says he's going to marry an English.
Do you mind if I ask you a couple of questions?
Of course not.
What basis do you have for your claim of foul play?
Lew Buckwalter was a craftsman. I don't believe he would have made a roof that would collapse.
Talking about Miss Lichtman. This was an industrial accident.
How do you know that?
Because it says right here in black and white.
Do you believe everything that you read, Mr. Kelso?
You and Buckwalter weren't married?
No.
Then how did you become his beneficiary?
We were family friends.
I think you entrapped this Buckwalter hump. I think that's your game, sister. You're the bird with the broken wing type that all the guys feel sorry for. Buckwalter gave you everything, didn't he?
He was my friend. Can you prove any different, Mr. Kelso?
Looks like I was mistaken. You expect me to reopen this case because you come in here walking that walk? Well, I'm not buying it. I think you should tell me what the hell is going on.
You really want to know?
Yes.
We were interned together on Ellis Island, resident alien Germans whose parents had been killed by Nazis. Do you see the irony in that, Mr. Kelso? We spent 4 years there.
So the roof collapsed, accidents happened. What exactly are you trying to achieve here, Miss Lichtman?
Exactly what I said. I want that building thoroughly investigated.
You expect me to believe that you have no ulterior motive? That money means nothing to you?
I believe that money has value. I believe your work defines who you are, and you should be paid relative to the quality of your work. If you wish to simply interrogate me for your own enjoyment, Mr. Kelso, then I will answer no more questions. Here is my number. Call me when you're prepared to help.
Do you think this would fit too light for my complexion?
I'll be in touch.
It's quite hard to concentrate when you're standing there staring at me. I'm not gonna ask what you do.
Mr. Benson would like to see you in his office, Jack. Upstairs. Come on, I'll walk you up.
It's 1947, not 1927. Of course a girl can ask a fella out.
Mr. Benson? You wanted to see me?
Ah, yes, Jack. I'm just trying out a new putter. I noticed Elsa Lichtman in the lobby.
It's the weirdest thing, Mr. Benson.
Call me Curtis, Jack. This is California.
Like I said, Curtis, this is a very strange case.
How so, Jack?
That lady, Elsa Lichtman, is refusing a 20 grand payout.
Elsa Lichtman is hardly a lady, Jack. She's a jazz musician. Plays at the Blue Room in Hollywood. She has a fine pair of lungs, now that I think
of it. She's the beneficiary of this guy, Lou Buckwalter. He was killed in an industrial accident working for Elysian Fields Developments. You know Elysian?
I'm familiar with Leland Monroe. We move in similar circles.
Well, Ms. Lichtman is making some pretty serious accusations. She says the case stinks and that
something She's a very highly strung girl, Jack. Strung out might be a better way to put it.
It's a pretty generous payment, Curtis. I think I should look into
it. Is there anything wrong with the paperwork, Kelso?
No, there isn't, Mr. Benson.
I didn't think so. Pay the case out and get her off our backs.
I can't make her take the money,
Deal with it, Jack. Do your fucking job. Do I have to do everything?
No, sir, you don't.
Fine, Jack. Fine. You know I have the greatest confidence in you.
Thanks, Mr. Benson.
The main reason Santa's so jolly is because he knows where all the bad girls are.
Your car, Mr. Kelso.
Thanks, kid. That's not how my pop taught me to mix it. Someone is cutting corners. Leland Monroe, the man with the grin. Looks like he doesn't like to be disappointed. bulldozing and starting again.
Can't be walking around down here.
I'm Jack Kelso from California Fire and Life.
I don't care if you're from the Vatican. Buzz off.
I'm investigating the accidental death of a Lou Buckwalter and...
You deaf? Do I have to beat on you?
Looks like you do.
You're a real asshole.
I came to see the house where Lou Buckwalter died. You were just about to offer to show me the way.
It's out the gate and three houses down to the left. Don't know what you're looking for, smart guy. There's nothing there.
Then I'll poke around in the rubble.
Fine. As long as you're out of my sight.
Well, harmony is right here by Miss Evelyn Knight.
The place falls down and then they bulldoze it. What gives here?
Piece this together.
Want to grab me too with ketchup on the roof here?
That's not right.
Louts, what was that for?
Keystone Films? Who gets their lumber from a film studio? Jack Kelso, California Fire and Life Investigator. I need an address on the Keystone Film Company.
The address is 658 North Wilton Place. Is there anything else?
No, thank you, ma'am.
Come on. your car. Got a job to do. What's your problem?
I work for California Fire and Life. I'm looking into an industrial accident.
Here?
No, not here. The housing development over on Normandy Avenue.
So?
I found some lumber over there, had the Keystone name printed on it.
We've been closed since 41. Never quite made the transition to talkies. The Suburban Redevelopment Fund are pulling the place down.
Know anything about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund?
Nix.
Mind if I take a look around?
I'm kind of hungry. If someone was to leave a couple of bucks here, I might wander down the street and get a cup of coffee.
Is there a key to the gate?
No. The only guys who go in or out are some delivery guys from Elysian Fields. They're working on a housing development over at Wilton and Santa Monica. You'll have to hop it.
See what the rich and powerful have to say for themselves.
Artistic temperament are often of a fragile mental disposition.
It's a short step from miscreant to recidivism, Doctor.
Very true. But I think we could all agree that the City of Angels does rather well basking in the reflection of the motion picture industry.
Hear, hear. And it's something that every sucker getting off a train at Union Station wants a part of. Gentlemen, we're here to sell the American dream. And Hollywood is our greatest advertiser.
So, how is your new development selling, Leland?
Cannot throw them up fast enough, Ray.
And that's part of the problem, Leland. Washington is receiving steady complaints. There's a clamor for public
housing. God damn it, Ray.
Public housing is tantamount to communism. Now, that's why we fought this goddamn war. I'm telling you, it's Reds via the back door.
You can't have it both ways, Leland. The new freeways are being built to service all your developments out in the boondocks. They're all being built with government money.
The GI Bill is government money.
There's a difference.
What difference?
The GI money ends up in my pocket.
I hope you mean our pockets, Leland. We're all investors.
Of course, Curtis.
So, when will the freeway bond be passed on?
It still has to be ratified. It takes a long time to raise $3 billion.
I need to find a Gainwell or a telephone.
In a great day for the future of Los Angeles, civic leaders and businessmen joined forces to launch the Suburban Redevelopment Fund. The Suburban Redevelopment Fund pledges...
One way to keep the cost down. Too bad it won't support a roof. Operator, Los Angeles Police Dispatch, if it's not too much trouble. This is Jack Kelso, investigator for California Fire and Life. Can you put me through to Curtis Benson, please?
Just a moment, please, Mr. Kelso.
Jack, how can I help?
Do you know anything about the Suburban Redevelopment Fund, Mr. Benson?
I've heard of them, Jack. Building new homes for GIs.
With green lumber that was used on movie sets.
Jack, are you working the Buckwalter case?
Mr. Benson? Are you part of the Suburban Redevelopment Fund?
Jack, I want you to listen very clearly. Call Miss Lickman. Call her as soon as you hang up. Arrange to see her tonight and get her to agree to the settlement. Do it tonight. Do you hear me?
Yes, sir.
End of story, Jack. I don't want to hear another word about Elsa Lickman or Lou Buckwalter.
Can you put me through to Michigan 221?
Putting the call through.
Hello?
Ms. Lichtman, it's Jack Kelso.
Yes, Mr. Kelso.
I've been looking into your case.
Yes, and what have you found?
It doesn't look good. I need to see you.
Meet me at the Blue Room. I work there tonight. I take a break around 9. I'll be waiting at the stage door. We can talk then. Auf Wiedersehen, Mr. Kelso.
Thank you.
Don't suppose I'll make a plea, 'cause baby, you know I'm guilty.
What were you doing with him?
I was doing what you asked.
I didn't ask you to meet him in an alleyway.
Why do you snarl at me? Your friend came to ask me to accept the insurance.
He's not my friend, Elsa.
I think he's a brave man, and you have placed him in great danger. You've involved him in something, and he has no idea of the risks. Can you live with that, Cole?
Elsa, I need his help. And he hates my guts.
Forget the past, Cole. He deserves a chance to say no. If he helps you, let it be on his terms.
I'll go see him in the morning.
Tell the cook these were some good drinks.
California and the West Coast with music and variety.
Nice wiring job, fellas. Keep them in the dark.
You lose something, Mac?
I thought these private eye types were all wise guys with smart mouths.
Looks like the snappy repartee has all dried up.
Get on with it.
What's your hurry, Mac? You got some place to go?
You ever do the cat and mouse routine without a gun in your hand?
Now that's more like it.
Let's put a few gaps in. All right, let's dance.
You're a worn tough guy. You should learn to take a hint. Get him downstairs and into the trunk. Sure, he turned up all right. He's wishing he didn't. He's in the trunk. He's going nowhere. The boys introduced themselves. What do you want done with him, Mr. Monroe? Yeah, I know a good place. We'll pick up a shovel and a pick on the way. It's up in the hills behind Griffith Park. We'll deal with that German bitch next.
Hey,
Elsa.
What the hell?
Sorry, pal. Desperate times. Time for this! So you're still carrying that Army 45, Cole?